Sportbets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. Sportbets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
All right, welcome back, everybody. We are just about ready with the game. At least we have people joining the server. So glad you wanted to join us here. This is Rumor on the Fire, and we have VODS Pro versus Fnatic. Best of one game for the SLTV Starseries, and this time I do have Hika with me. So let me see if I can call him up on Skype, and hopefully it won't bug out too much like it looked like it just did. Oh no, it's working again. Skype's a very emotional program. Can't mess with it too much. What's up, Hika?
Hello.
How are you doing?
I am doing good, Anders. How are you this afternoon?
I'm doing just fine. Much better now that you're here. It's really nice to not be alone anymore.
Oh, no problem, Anders. Anything for you, man.
Well, I really appreciate it. And, you know, I wanted to surprise you, but you sort of caught on as well. That we wanted to see if we can get you up to 1,000 before you even showed up. And now we're just 150 short. Yay, 10,000 followers almost.
I opened my phone after I closed my stream, and I'm like, whoa, 60 new notifications. There's got to be something wrong here. And I checked, and yeah, we're almost there.
Yeah, so that was the goal for the evening, was to get Hiko to 10,000 followers on Twitter for as a sort of thank you for you tuning in and helping us out until we can pay you at some point in the future, which we obviously would like to do. But so far, it isn't quite possible. So we can pay you in followers, maybe. And I guess that's a start as well. So if you guys want to go and follow, we just need 150 more. And if obviously we can reach more than 10,000, that's great. But the previous max I think we've ever done for anyone was 600 in one day, I think. So 1,000 would be pretty cool.
Yeah, we've already broken that. I've had, what, like 800? I think 800 on the dot so far.
Yep. So not at all bad. And obviously, if you follow Hiko, I mean, you'll make him happy, but you can also keep up with when he's streaming. Because Hiko, you do a lot of streaming, don't you?
I do. I have a pretty solid schedule. And if mostly, I think most of my viewers are European because I do it early in the day for me. But it's a lot of fun. I love doing what I do.
It is really good, and I mean, let's do a show of hands. How many people in the chat right now has the Hiko golf clap? Can some people test it out? Because I know that we do have some of the Hiko homies also tuning in and sort of subscribing to both channels. So, yeah, why not do that?
Do you get some VDPs still sometimes?
We do every once in a while. Yeah, it comes up. It definitely does. So I'd be expecting, you know, once the delay catches up, we'll see some golf claps in the chat in just a moment, unless they're all mysteriously AFK. But obviously we do have Gnagana. We'll Debitor as well. It's all good. It's all good. There are definitely some people out there with a golf clap. All right. Well, Hiko, we do have a kind of a scary match coming up here. Because I don't know if you saw, I guess you didn't because you were just streaming now, and then I know you just had a little bit to drink and stuff like that, but just now, Fnatic utterly destroyed Epsilon on Mirage, 16-5, and it was no contest at all. Like, Epsilon just had no idea what was happening, and Fnatic were hitting all their shots. So based on that, I'm a little bit worried for this game, because before that match, I would have said definitely VODS Pro on Inferno. But now I'm not so sure.
I actually just caught like the tail end of that match, and I was surprised to see it was like 15 to whatever it was. Who was playing? It was, you said VODS Pro and Epsilon?
Or Epsilon Fnatic? And Fnatic.
Okay.
So Fnatic, they, you know, with Crimson and Olofmeister now in the lineup, they've been looking good since they added those two, but they were looking really good just now. And Epsilon have been looking good with FXO. I don't know if you've been catching some of all the hype about him playing. Epsilon.
No, I saw him playing so good the last couple of days.
Yeah, exactly. They beat Hellraisers and everything, and he was one of the main engines to that victory. So I think people have been pretty confident in Epsilon's abilities up until now, maybe.
Yeah. I mean, Fnatic is definitely not a team to count out, though, by any means. I guess their recent results of their tournaments might have been weird, but as you said, they did change their roster up a bit. And I mean, if they just crushed Epsilon on Inferno, which Epsilon is definitely not a bad team on Inferno. They definitely are. I mean, Shoxi on Inferno is definitely a force. I didn't see how he was doing, but...
Oh, they were playing Mirage, sorry, against Epsilon.
Oh, okay.
But that was the map where FXGO just crushed up Hellraisers. So,
yeah,
that's...
I saw that yesterday.
And he didn't this time. It felt like Fnatic's style was just one that Epsilon couldn't really deal with. And they made a lot of mistakes, but... Let's not hang around with that. We'll see if we can't, you know, move into this game a little bit. And I don't know, virtus.pro, they're a strong Inferno team. So is Fnatic. So I really don't know what to say. I guess almost all top teams are pretty good at playing Inferno in one way or another. Like, you kind of have to be, don't you?
I mean, if you look at all the last tournaments, I mean, Inferno was the most common map played out of all the tournaments to date, I think. Hmm. So everybody needs to... Everyone knows Inferno. Everyone's played it a million times, and
exactly.
Some people do some weird things, but not really.
No, there is. It's sort of a map you can't avoid playing, so you might as well just practice it. So we'll see. We do have 10 people on, and the knife is about to come up. So welcome to the show, everyone. This is Room on Fire. We've got virtus.pro versus Fnatic. Best of one game for the SLTV Star Series Season 10. I'm Anders, and with me is Hiko from Complexity. So once again, Hiko, thank you very much for joining us. And remember, guys, to follow the stream and subscribe if you want to help us out. And also go and follow Hiko on Twitter. I think we're just now 14 followers away from hitting the 10,000 follower mark for Hiko. As a sort of thank you for him for tuning in. That means we will have gotten him almost 1,000 followers in one day, so that's really cool. Just 14 more guys. But what do you think, Hiko? If you had to pick a winner here, virtus.pro or Fnatic, who is it going to be?
I have to give it to virtus.pro, I think. I've seen them play Inferno a lot of times, and I've played them on Inferno a lot of times. I like the way they play it against a team like Fnatic, where... I would expect them to push everything. I think virtus.pro will have the upper hand.
Now, you see, I would have agreed a lot before I've witnessed this new Fnatic style. Because Fnatic now are playing a lot like, at least on the CT side, no, sorry, on the Terrace side, they're playing a lot like Na'Vi's playing, where they just really slowly walk everywhere and look for picks before they really do anything. They're down to 40, 30. Yeah, it's really weird because that's obviously...
Even JW, they're able to hold him just to play passive?
So far. I mean, on the CT side, it's a little bit different. But on the Terra side, they've actually really slowed it down, at least on Mirage. We'll see if it's the same on here on Inferno. It's going to be virtus.pro starting on the CT side and Fnatic on the Terra side. And I think we just need to learn a little bit about how Fnatic play. But yeah, so far, they've been playing really steadily. They've actually all bought body armor. What do you think about this? And look at virtus.pro. It's the exact opposite on their side. So this is grenades versus armor.
Yeah.
Definitely a little bit strange. From this kind of buy, I would guess that means at one point, like once the time has run down enough for Fnatic to get bored, they're all just going to rush one side because, you know, they have the armor to do that.
Right, exactly. And, you know, maybe you're right. It looks like Fnatic is. This is a new Fnatic. This is a Fnatic I'm not used to seeing. They're actually walking around.
Yeah. It is really different. But I guess it's good that you're figuring it out now as well if you're going to be playing against them at some point.
Yeah.
Oh, Snack spots one and really wants the grenade out, but he's actually just going to re-peek. Doesn't want to waste the grenade, so I think that's a good idea. Flashes once, then goes to take a peek, and all of my just waiting for him again. They are just waiting for a pick-off. Now they're going to go up on the banana, see if they can find one, but Neo's smartly going to fall back. That's a great headshot, though, to take down JW, and a great start for virtus.pro. Still leaving Flusher over here, and I think they're going to actually run back and go for the A-bomb site. Question is if they can make the breakthrough once they go for it here. Well, no. Not like that. Oh my god, Snacks with some absolutely great pistol shooting coming out now. Flusher is going to get caught as well, and he's going to go down. So that's it, a flawless pistol round.
Yeah, not a singular frag from Fnatic, but I mean, that first kill that Neo got at B was so crucial. He was able to get that first kill, and because of that, he knew he could hear there was only one more guy there. So he flashed it or smoked it, and the other guy that was playing B fell all the way back to A. It was just a murder when they ran up mid.
Yeah, so I guess the weak point of playing to get pickoffs is if you never really get them, all you're doing is wasting a lot of time, and you know, by the time they went in, virtus.pro had a pretty good handle on the situation. Now it's going to be a bit of a slaughter down in Boiler Room, but Pasha will pick up two great kills, Snacks and Biotic picking up another one each, and Crims really wants to pick up this last kill here. We'll get by Ali, but he's going to go down right afterwards, so... Two kills coming in, actually. Snacks and Bindy both going down, and I guess that's pretty well done from Fnatic.
Yeah, that was like a typical Fnatic round. Three people rush out the boiler as fast as they can, as two people rush out the halls as fast as they can. It's actually kind of surprising that they were able to pick up two kills like that, but they were.
Yeah, it sort of looked like they were gonna die a lot quicker in that boiler room. Obviously, they haven't had a bomb plant yet, so they're not going to be buying anything. They have invested in one flash and one smoke, and... I'm wondering, yeah, so when is this flash going to happen? I think they're going to flash and try and run out Boiler Room again. So I kind of like this idea. We'll see if it's going to work. They get the flash on Pasha, but then Snacks is still down here in the pit, and they pick up one more kill. Pasha trying to see if he can get another one. JW caught in a bit of a corner here in a one-on-four as well, and he's going to go down. But what do you think about the idea in general, Hiko, of just having that flash in middle?
It's solid. It's good if they play in front of middle. And you see a lot of CT teams when they play Inferno, they don't... It's hard for some teams to actually decide whether to play in middle or play like passive and play in sight and pit. And for virtus.pro, obviously, it wasn't hard for them. They knew they were saving. They knew they were going to have pistols. So they felt they played passive. And obviously, Fnatic got not one kill on them.
Good grenade landing down on Neo there. That was, who was that? Flusher throwing that one in. But now they're back to playing really slowly again, which is, you know, they have Flusher over in Banana. They have JW in the middle. They have a couple of people over by the apartments. They're just looking for someone from virtus.pro. And maybe Snacks is going to be it. Oh, they could have pretty killed him then, but they just couldn't spot him for the smoke. And now he's going to be falling back. So a missed opportunity for Fnatic. But how are you liking this style? I mean, do you think it can work?
I mean, we'll have to see. I don't know. I think they need to get an AWP in JW's or Olive Master's hand, although it is T Inferno, so they probably won't get one. But, I mean, you are right. They definitely are going a lot more passive, a lot slower than, you know, as I said, they used to go. So, let's see if they're able to, like, throw a good fake or throw a good execute and take A with this. That's what it's looking like.
Yeah, shaping up, Jordan. You know, just look at the time here. This is very much not Fnatic. Like 35 seconds left. They are going to smoke off towards the car, which should give them an entrance up from the apartments. By Ali being flashed a lot as well. JW goes down. Crims falls. Flush are going to go down. Now it's just Olofmeister in a 1-on-5, and this is such a solid lockdown coming in from virtus.pro. I mean, Olofmeister doing a great job here, but it is not enough. So 4-0 early on here, and apart from Olofmeister going insane and getting the first three kills of the game for himself, he had zero before, just like Flusher and Pronax do now. That would have been a flawless round again for virtus.pro.
Yeah. I feel like this style of play against virtus.pro just doesn't work. Like, that slow kind of take everything really slow and try to throw like a really late execute. The virtus.pro players are very good at getting information. Neo and whoever else plays B with him are very good at taking B control. And if there's nobody there, they're going to run into four guys stacking the A site. And that's what they just ran into right there.
Yeah, not exactly ideal. And they didn't pick up any kills either. JW trying to hide, but I think you just see his shoulder then. And obviously they're back to ecoing on the Fnatic side here. Taz does pick up the kill on Flusher, who did shoot his friend in Neo. And Pronax with a good kill here. But it is way too late in the day, and they are going to come and find him. Bailey right around the corner actually goes down. So Pronax, I mean, apart from the fact that the bomb is so far away, he has enough time to do something here.
Yeah, and Pasha is already flanking around the halls. So even if Taz dies, he'll get cut. Yeah, Pasha with the flank.
5-0. These have been some pretty one-sided rounds, the first three rounds, but do you think Fnatic can turn it around if they just get a single round in here? And actually, oh, just to interrupt myself, they picked up an AWP here on JW.
I think they could. This is definitely like the momentum swing round here. They have two buy rounds right in a row, so they need to win one of these rounds for sure. And I think the wrong thing that they could do right now is try to keep going slow. Try to wait for a 30-second execute. But I have a feeling that since JW has an AWP, he'll try to go either up B or up mid and try to get a quick pick. So probably going to be a different round than we saw before.
Snacks is right here. He somehow misses that AWP shot, which looked like it was going to be dead on. But I was going to say he has an AWP as well, which is interesting. And I think they should have really had a kill right then already, virtus.pro. So Fnatic should count themselves very lucky that they managed to stay alive. But it's not the normal thing for us to see Snacks AWPing either.
No, I don't think Snacks AWPs very much at all. I'm surprised. Why wouldn't he just give it to Pasha, right?
Yeah, exactly. Maybe they're switching it up a little bit. It's interesting anyway. So far, not too much success, but we can't really judge him on that one shot. I think now they're going for what we sometimes call an NIP-type execute, where they have Olofmeister making noise here. Boiler Room actually going to take down Pasha. Turns around here. Snacks can't really see him, and then the rest are going to go for the B-bomb side, and he's actually forcing Taz into connector, or into the archway. Really good job by Olofmeister so far. Looking for one more pick here, but the rest of the push happening. What is Snacks doing? He's rushing up behind them. This is the most crazy round I've seen in a very long time, and Snacks goes down. He just can't find the kill. Now it's on Neo, up on the coils here, and they're all coming for him. If he can hold this bomb site alone, then he truly is a god. He's down in the smoke, just waiting. He's going to be rushing out and goes down to JW. So now Bayali is alone. Hiko, what the hell just happened?
I mean, all right. So Olofmeister goes up boiler, goes up mid, gets a kill, and he has all of the arch, or all of the long side held down, right? So that pulls one of the B guys out of B. At the same time, Snacks had already pushed through halls, so they had to make the call whether they were all up mid already or if they were falling back to B. And obviously, he pushed through B, and he saw them going B, and unfortunately, he died. But it was too late because Olofmeister was already coming around through spawn. I think he actually killed a second guy, Taz, falling away from B. So Neo just kind of got overran, but it was... It was a good play by Snacks, but at the same time, it was probably a better play by Olofmeister, shutting down the rotate, killing the first guy at Banana, and forcing Neo to try to hold the site in what was a 1v4.
And Snacks not going to be picking up an AWP again. I don't think he could afford it, but having missed those two shots, I think he's decided it's not worth it anyway. I mean, it's a bit much right now. Fnatic are counting on Olofmeister to just carry, this whole game. They do need JW and Flusher and Crims. Actually, everyone else, apart from Olofmeister, right now needs to step it up and get some kills in here.
Yeah. Actually, Pronex is shooting in alt mid, thinking like they're spamming, while there's already a guy at the end of halls. I like that. That's like you see that people do that on LAN.
Hmm. Yeah, just to, if someone was going to peek thinking there was no one there,
right,
I see where you're coming from. Didn't quite work because Snacks is actually in a different position this time, but the previous couple of rounds he has been holding from that position, so I guess then it could have worked out. Flusher's jumping up on the top of the sandbags here, trying to look over the smoke, and in the meantime, they're walking up the middle here, and they need to be really careful. Oh, they Molotov that corner and force Pasha out, and I'm so happy. I've been calling for that play since forever. I really, really think that I've been seeing it in my mind's eye so many times that you could just Molotov that corner and force someone out. Thank you very much, Fnatic, for making that work. Now Taz is going to be falling back, and that's a good start.
You know what we should see? They should, like, shoot the bell and then throw the Molotov.
Oh, the every victory time. Bell? well, I think it's a bit too early for Fnatic to sign the victory or sing the victory bell out here, but they are making a really good comeback into this round. Another potentially flawless round coming out from Fnatic, and Neo is now going to be in a 1-on-5 here. Not really an ideal position. Olofmeister, the only guy really hunting heavily, and he has like 17 HP. Tells you something about the mentality on Olofmeister, doesn't it?
Yeah. I mean, Virtus.pro knows that Fnatic is still kind of low on money, although they won two in a row. They don't have much money themselves, but they're going to probably end up saving here and buy next. But even if Neo was able to get a few more kills, it keeps Fnatic's money low. So that next round when they buy, if they win, Fnatic's money will, obviously stay low and stay at a point where they can control a half.
Yeah, definitely really important. A bit of a shame for Fnatic. Two flawless rounds like that consecutively would have been really something. They could have bought a lot more. So those three rifles have a real impact. You're absolutely right. And let's see. CSET 75 up in the hallways. I like the idea. This is definitely where they are really, really useful. And Snacks will pick up the first one. Second goes to Bayali. Takes down Crims. And the bomb is even lost up here. So this is an absolutely horrendous start for Fnatic.
Yeah, you never want to be in a 3v5 against a team that's full saving as a T-side as well. With the bomb down up in halls.
No, not really smart. I mean, at least they can recover the bomb, but yeah, when a team is saving, I guess the last thing you really want to do is get as close to them as you will up in the hallways here. Please tell me they can pick up the bomb.
Can they get the bomb?
You must.
He has to try to get through the door.
Okay, he can pick it up. I guess the chance for them now is to take down by Alien Snacks here and win the bomb site back. They can do that. There's a 3-on-2 going on here, but they've picked up AKs, and Fnatic potentially about to throw away the one lead they could have had here.
Yeah, and they've cleared banana. Neo's already pushing through, so there's going to be four people at A while they're trying to hit it. Neo's going to catch a guy in the back here, too. Yeah, or Pasha, actually.
Oh, my God. What a round coming out here from virtus.pro. Looking absolutely fantastic. JW takes a kill with the AWP, then jumps down like a maniac. Takes down another one, but it's all just showmanship at this point. Not going to win the round because of it. And that's 6-2 now, and Fnatic throwing away a huge chance to get right back into the game. That is, I mean, that's almost as good as winning a pistol round right there.
Yeah, and you know, anytime you think the CTs are going to save, usually teams don't bother with hulls because of exactly what just happened. If they have CZs or if they have, like, shotguns, you're just like a sitting duck if you try to go hulls or jump on boiler. And that's exactly where virtus.pro got their first two kills. They got one at the bottom of hall stairs and one guy jumping up boiler and pretty much took zero damage for it, too.
Fnatic, on the other hand, have taken a lot of damage already from just the one grenade that Pasha threw. So that was a really nice grenade from the Polish player. And we'll see if they can do it again here, Fnatic. I mean, they had two rounds where they almost, you know, won flawlessly. The question is if they can bring it back, whatever it was that was going on. And I think both those rounds really happened because of a great entry frag that Fnatic got. Which is good, but it's also bad because if you never get the entry frag, then what are you going to do?
Yeah. And I guess that's kind of the new Fnatic. They rely on, if their executes don't work, they rely on, you know, going, doing exactly what you say, going up, trying to get a pick, and trying to take something after that.
That is what it feels like, at least until now. We'll see if they do have something different to show us. A really, really good timed smoke coming out from Bayali here. 35 seconds left, and look at this. virtus.pro actually saving so many smokes that by the time Fnatic decide to push, they're going to have to rush through smokes right here. Snags actually goes down. Nicely played by Pronax, but I'm not sure it's enough. Bayali controlling the weapon, points out with the pistol. Olofmeister actually still picks up the kill, and Pasha's going to miss the AWP shot. He goes down to JW. So this was a very, very fortunate push from Fnatic. I'm not sure if they should have been able to do what they just did. Taz running around the corner here takes down JW, and it's not over yet. It's a 2-on-3, and virtus.pro, they feel like they might be able to retake this site, and maybe they will.
Neo needs to kill two guys in boiler. Even if he kills one, there's no way he'll expect two of them there.
No, Taz is now walking in, and actually, they hear him already. Taz not going to look in the corner, because he didn't expect two people to be there either, and now Neo is trapped in a weird position. He's going to go down, so good after-pump positions from Fnatic, but did it feel to you like, I felt to me at least, like virtus.pro actually should have been able to defend that because of how late they saved their smokes to?
Yeah, exactly. They had a smoke on short and long, and some guy jumped through the short smoke.
Yeah.
And got under the porch and just killed Snacks. I feel like you're right. If he gets that kill, it probably swings the other way. But yeah, just pretty, Fnatic's very fortunate to have won their round, for sure.
Yeah, because normally on Inferno, I would say, in either A or B, if you still have a smoke that you can put up when there's about 40 seconds left, you're doing a pretty good job. So, and this time it's 35 seconds, so that's actually really rare, I think, to be able to save a smoke that long. On the CT side, that is.
Well, usually you see the smokes late at banana. You don't really see them at A.
So a bit of a shame for virtus.pro they couldn't pick up that round. Grenade will follow. JW actually opening up over at the B-bomb site with a shot onto Neo. That leaves Taz alone. They only have two rifles and a couple of pistols here, so maybe Fnatic can have a bit of a comeback in this round.
Yeah, and virtus.pro is actually gambling three to stay at A, which it looks like all of them are going towards B now. It's going to be pretty unfortunate for Neo here, for Taz.
Yeah, not easy at all. He smokes it up, which I think is a pretty good idea, but also that obviously reveals his position. They definitely know where he is, and they are just going to try and see if they can grenade him down, which is a bit of a tricky idea. He's still hiding in the smoke, and they're spamming right through. He peeks out, takes down Flusher. The bomb is down, but Taz is here to take a couple of kills, and actually he equalizes it. We're back into a 3-on-3. Pronax is going to fall. Crims peeks out too soon, and now it's on JW. He gets the shot through on Snags and brings him down to about 12 HP, but it's not enough here. Oh, he's going to get the kill and then burns to death. Great retake by virtus.pro. Puts it as 7-3. Oh my god, Fnatic should not have lost that round.
I have to give it to Taz that round. That smoke and just hiding there for so long, he gets the first kill and he kills the guy that planted right after.
Yes.
Taz, really, really nice, you know, smart play, smoking himself off and just sitting there for so long. And obviously, he was able to pull two frags from it, so.
Definitely really nicely done. Fnatic, They were still able to buy this round, but I think actually mostly because they put the bomb down, so they got the $800 bonus. Otherwise, I'm not sure they wouldn't have been forced to eco anyway. So, feels like we're at a critical junction in the game here, Hiko, where both teams have such a bad economy that losing a round here would probably force an eco on either side.
Yeah, I would think so. Snack should have actually got that kill. I'm surprised he didn't kill Crimsler. Did you see where he was there?
Yeah, yeah. Just by the by quad, right?
He was on top of the...
Oh, he was on top.
Boost spot, yeah.
Oh, I didn't see. I just saw on the minimap. Interesting. Oh, now I see his body is. I was even wrong. There we go. So he was up here on the tiny, tiny balcony, as we sometimes call it. Because it is really tiny.
Yeah.
Well, this is a good start for Fnatic, but this game so far has been really unpredictable. I feel like we've seen some big swings in individual rounds, so I'm not going to call it yet. Bialy is in a really good position. I mean, we've seen people defend Pit from almost any number of attackers, and he's going to get flashed in. Oh no, but Pasha gets flashed. That was a golden opportunity, and it turned to bronze right at the end. Now Bialy really grenaded down here, 32 HP, still surviving. It's going to be going down just as I say that. Now Taz is the only one defending. The bomb is going to be planted with not that much time left, but this is a 2-on-2, and who do you think this is favoring right now, Fnatic or VODS.pro?
With that smoke right there, I would have to say Fnatic, especially because it's forcing both players to come around to short side. I think Fnatic should be able to take this round, but...
This is tricky. Olofmeister with a good shot, but they're both so low that one click is going to be all it takes. And Olofmeister's trying to buy time hiding here. Taz doesn't have a kit. He's jumping up, and he does get the kill. Is there enough time? He picks up a kit as well, and there's going to be just enough. If he hadn't got the kit, he would have lost the round, but I'm pretty sure he's going to be able to do it. No, what? Are you joking?
No.
No. No. All right, Hiko. Well, you know the timing's better than I do, but I thought he had that.
That was very close. That was one of those ones where it's too close. You can't tell. It could go either way. And unfortunately for VODS.pro, it was too late.
Oh my God. Well, that was, I mean, I felt like he deserved it, Taz, right? They deserved to get that after that cool retake, but just doesn't happen.
It shouldn't have even came that close anyway. Fnatic should have won that much easier.
Mm.
And I don't really know why the first guy from Fnatic stayed at like the default plant spot. And he just got killed pretty easily, but... Oh, well.
Olofmeister's about to be found out here. Bialy has discovered him already, and Snacks is coming up from behind. But Olofmeister, is he really going to live through this? Pasha in a cool position, but JW still takes him down. That's unfortunate. And VODS.pro, I don't know. This round, they could have got away with a lot more, but they just had... Oh, they were just a little bit unfortunate. Sorry about that. I don't want to exit the game. That's JW with the triple kill, and Snags goes down as well. So Olofmeister somehow stays alive. And we're now at 7-5. And what do you think, Hiko? This is a weird game so far because we had five rounds in a row from VODS.pro, and it looked like those weren't just five rounds. They were five rounds that they played almost flawlessly. And now it's 7-5, and I'm not sure what to make of it.
I mean, you kind of said it. Fnatic has been getting those really early picks. There was like a few rounds where JW just goes up. He went up B one round and just killed Neo or whoever it was. And there was one round where somebody got a kill in Halls really early. So I would like to see VODS.pro play a little bit more passive like they were at the beginning. But I guess it's kind of hard now that Fnatic are doing what you said, like the NIP style defaults, where they're just kind of walking around and just walking into places. Here you go. The go into B with one flash.
The go into B with one flash strat. Well, Neo and Taz picking off a player each, and Taz doesn't really have to challenge anymore. Does just have to wait at this point. He's going to take down the bomb as well. Really smooth play coming out from Taz, and I like it. Even with the flank coming around here from JW, it's almost... Might be able to pick up two quick kills here. Going for it. There's the one, and the... No, not the double! That is a little bit unfortunate, because that probably should have been a double kill, and if he had got it, they would have maybe... Yeah, they would have got the bomb down as well. It would have been a huge double coming in there. Ah, well, I'm not sure they would have won the round, but what do you think? I mean, that double kill would have made a difference in the round?
I actually didn't catch it, but he died. It was in the bomb site, right? So
he walked up through flowers all the way through construction and came behind two of them, one on coils and one that was hiding to the right.
Right, and he only killed one.
And
so
they
probably would have got the planet at least, right?
Yeah.
So they would definitely be better looking into this round. They would have all been able to have AKs instead of having Flesha with Galil. But what do they say? That's the way the cookie crumbles, right?
Yeah. Oh, Pasha. What? He still picks up the kill somehow. I have no idea how. And now he's going to fall back. I think both Bialy and Pasha should have gone down at the beginning of this round, but Fnatic not having much luck at the beginning here, the 14th round. And the big problem is, if they lose this round, they're going to be ecoing. This is actually the difference between virtus.pro making it 10-5 or Fnatic finishing 8-7. Because of the economy, that might very well be the difference. That's rare that we get to see this big of a swing because of one round. Flush is looking to peek. He's going to take down Neo. It's a very, very important kill. Fnatic need this round a lot.
Yeah, and it's looking pretty even right now. I mean, they have two people that are low on both sides and two people with 100. So it's pretty much dead even in terms of HP.
Oh, but look at this. Look at Pronax just walking up here. Pasha's actually waiting, which is also great play from Pasha, but Pronax will pick up the kill. Now, the weight of the world on Taz here. virtus.pro only going to have money to buy on one, maybe on Taz. He could pick up a FAMAS or something, but everything is on Taz, and he's waiting. He takes the first kill, and then he goes down. And now, a very tough retake on the shoulders of Bialy and Snags. I mean, with how low Bialy is, feels like Fnatic should be able to defend this.
Yeah, and they're both coming from Banana, and there's a smoke up. I would like to see them just save at this point. I mean, they don't have much money. They don't really have a chance here anymore. So, yep, they're saving.
All right. You made the call before they even did it, but you're absolutely right. They decided to do that. So, I guess one of them can drop for Neo and then Taz and Pasha. Yeah, so they might actually have a much better buy than I thought if they managed to save these two. And JW goes down. Fnatic are looking for them, and they got to be a little bit careful as well. They don't have a lot of money.
And Fnatic has no money either, so they might run into a situation next round where one guy might not have nades because two guys lived, but we'll have to see.
So, what's your call here, Hiko? Six rounds on Fnatic, is that enough for the first half?
I've never seen Fnatic play CT. This is one of the first times I've watched the Fnatic new roster, so I don't really know. Right. I know virtus.pro has a pretty strong T, but we'll have to see how Fnatic plays CT.
It feels like a really even game. In spite of the great start that virtus.pro had, it sort of feels like the Swedes have somehow caught up. But I guess you're right. It does come down to how well Fnatic are going to be playing on the other side. And that, I think, really often comes down to how well JW plays with the AWP. So, I mean,
does he play a lot like Kenny S, where he just kind of pushes pause with his AWP?
He still does that sometimes, yeah. But he's actually managed to restrain himself a lot recently when I've seen him on this map, where he does the peek, but if he fails, he actually doesn't re-peek. He just goes back. So it's a little bit more, you know, well, a little bit more civil in that sense. Pasha somehow shooting right around Pronax. Oh, so JW. I'm not sure JW realizes how lucky he is to be alive then. That was funny. Smoke goes off by Ali hiding underneath the canopy, and they're all rushing out right in the face of Pasha. He goes down. By Ali has revealed his position. They're shooting through, not really connecting. Now Taz comes in with a Mag 7 in hand. He's right around the corner. Great position for it, but he misses the shot incredibly. Now it's going to be down to Neo with a 5-7 in hand, and he's going to tip his hand early, and that will very likely be 8-7 here in favor of virtus.pro, but only a one-round lead. This was a really good round from Fnatic.
Yeah, and they did kind of the old style where they waited till about 45 seconds, I think, and they executed mid, and they rushed the long side to spawn, and they killed killed the B rotator and the guy playing arches without even losing a person. I mean, they still have five alive right now. So
that's really interesting. I think the way that Fnatic played that round and the way they got the entry facts, I think that's how they had imagined some of the first five rounds would have gone as well. But they just didn't, and they sort of stuck with it, even though they executed a little bit earlier. I think that's how Fnatic would like to play the T side in the future, I imagine. But if you're just joining us, then welcome to the stream. Second half is coming up in just 25 seconds. It is Fnatic versus virtus.pro. Best of one game SLTV Starseries. So thank you very much for joining us. It's been a pleasure so far. Of course, I'm here, but I also have Hiko from Complexity. So Hiko, once again, thank you for joining us. And I think we actually hit the 10,000 follower mark. But of course, if you guys want to go and follow Hiko and repay him even more, then, you know, we're just now 900 followers away from the 11,000 mark. So why not get it there? If you do follow Hiko, you can always you can keep up with when he streams. And I know, Hiko, you also have a habit of doing, like, you know, subscriber giveaways and stuff like that on your stream.
I do.
So, you know, you guys can... It's worth following. It's definitely a good stream. So do it. Definitely do it.
All right. Thank everybody. Thank you for the follows, for sure. Appreciate it, man.
That's the least we can do, right? It's the least we can do. Also, if you guys want to follow the channel, then do it. I think right now, Room on Fire is number 87 on the Twitch world rankings in terms of followers. But we want to get even higher. We want to, you know, carry the flag of Counter-Strike as long as we possibly can. So follow the channel, and we'll try and do the rest from our point of view and just spread the good word about what a fun game and this is. Now, the pistol round's coming up. And if virtus.pro win this one, Ah, well, they're not going to win the game because of this pistol round, but it'll be a good step in the right direction.
Yep, and you see they're doing kind of the same thing that Fnatic did. They're holding, they're playing passive. One guy towards B, four guy towards A. And I'm expecting kind of late hit somewhere here.
Yeah, and the weak point of the map right now, it feels to me like, is where JW is holding. If virtus.pro realize that they can go towards Arch and leave, you know, everyone at the A bomb site, that's pretty scary.
That's true. I mean, chances are he'll take a spot and fall back, but it looks like they're actually falling back to B. And this is a smart play because they only have Crims alone at B right now.
Yeah, and they even have the grenades for it. They have two smokes on virtus.pro, so even if Crims, you know, gets a kill and then falls back, he's actually just going to try and flash his way out, but he needs back up so quickly. Flashes out, Crims peaks, and he's already down to 8 HP. But the problem is the retake now, because of the smokes, is going to be so tough for Fnatic. A really good read from virtus.pro. Excellent game sense. There is Crims. He lived a little bit longer than maybe he should have, but that's a nice shot from JW. Can he get one more? He's going to go down. He actually ran in alone, which is not really a good idea. They had time to wait, and now they basically don't have any more time at all. Flusher and Pronax trying to see if they can retake it, but Flusher's getting overrun. He still picks up a kill somehow. Pronax with one more. Now it's a one-on-two, but I think enough time has passed here that Pronax really doesn't have a chance anymore. Taz will take him down, and that is going to be 9-7.
I think it was very smart on virtus.pro's side, and virtus.pro is very good at taking map control. They took B. They knew, I don't know if they actually knew Crims was the only one there, but they knew they dinked him, and so they took that extra step in clearing the garden area. Hmm. So they had two people there, so that Fnatic, you know, it puts so much more on them to try to take that back from two people holding like behind corners. So smart play by them, you know, taking the site and taking control of that early. And it really was helped them just secure the round.
Very nicely done. The call in itself to just go for that B bomb site and Crims being unable to do much of anything was... That just looked like exactly the right call. That looks like the sort of call you'd be able to make if you actually had a minimap like we do and you can see where the players are. You'd be like, all right, let's go for the B bomb site. But without a minimap, it's a little bit more tricky.
Yeah, and they're actually playing like they did on pistol again. Crims is just completely alone at B. Surprising.
Yeah, and they also don't have any body armor. What they have is one grenade on Flusher, but that's about it. So that's also a bit of a switch up from a lot of European teams that do like to pick up body armor and then P250s or CSET 75s in the eco rounds here, but they're not doing that right now. Good kills coming in here. It's actually going to be a 2-on-3. Not sure if they can win the round. The bomb is going to go down, and, well, Olofmeister will pick up one more. He's going to run right into Taz here, picks up a rifle, but it's got no more bullets in it, and actually Taz survives on 6 HP. You've got to be joking. If that had been a kill, that would have been really impressive. There was only 20 seconds left as well, so Olofmeister would have been able to hide for a long time. I think the low amount of bullets in the C set there really choked it for him.
Yeah, it's also worth noting something that's kind of cool that virtus.pro does is they had Neo and Pasha both with MP7s, and they send them first clearing stuff. That actually is very smart, and it actually is something that, you know, a lot I don't think a lot of teams do, but it's something to consider. Have two people buy, you know, low submachine guns, have them clear the eco spots. If they're saving, have the rifles fall back to their site. If they're not, if they end up getting the kills, well, then there you go. It still works.
Yeah, and if they go down, all you've given away is an MP7, which in the hands of someone without any armor is maybe not the most terrifying thing.
Against head armor, it doesn't really do much. So
yeah,
it definitely is worth it to kind of suicide them to get information.
Well, Crims, again, alone over here. It's the exact same setup for a third round in a row here for Fnatic. And that last round almost worked out, so can't really blame them for doing it. But seems like virtus.pro have decided this time it's time for a bit of an A push. And up in the apartments, not going to work out here. JW with a great kill. Flusher coming in with one. Taz is waiting smartly, and they just need to relax a little bit here, Fnatic. They actually have a pretty decent position right now. Ah, but it's not working out. Olofmeister is going to be flanking, but they're waiting right there. Taz playing smartly as ever, but it's Snags who picks up a triple kill. Still, these have actually, I mean, these have been pretty decent rounds for Fnatic. They've managed to do some damage to virtus.pro's economy, and now it's 11-7, and if Fnatic pick up this round, then there's no saying they can't come right back into this game. The dangerous part is if they lose it.
Yeah, This is definitely a huge run for Fnatic, and I'm interested to see if they try to gamble and try to play aggressive, or if they just play like a standard hold this round.
Oh, flash this out. Olofmeister actually gets flash from that, so not really sure what that was. He takes a shot right to the shoulder of Neo, who survives on 19 HP, so a good start.
But that had to be through the pillar, I think, right? To do that little damage?
Yeah, I think so. I actually haven't checked the damage fall off through those pillars. Maybe I should go and do that. But that new command is really, really useful, where you can see how much the damage fall off is exactly.
Yeah, really. It really is.
Well, still lots of grenades on VODS Pro, and obviously still a minute left on the clock, so they can do whatever they like at this point. But I'm liking the fact that they're leaving Crims here. I sort of wish they would leave all of my stay and then draw Crims back to the A-bomb site. Because when you have an AWP, you know, you can put a lot of pressure here or just hold Banana on your own, more or less. But instead, they're doing the opposite. No, are they? They're still keeping two people here.
Yeah, I don't agree with that. Now it looks like Olofmeister's falling back, but usually you keep the Opera there, because an Opera at Arch, all you need is two smokes, one library and one in Arch, and that Opera is completely useless.
Yeah, Flusher putting some shots for the smoke here, and actually it's going to be over at Banana, where Crims trades one for one. Flusher still waiting right here. He's going to be running away, and Snax is so close by. This is dangerous territory for Fnatic. Oh. Pronax goes down, and Fnatic completely outmaneuvered on this map. Just have no clue what's happening. I have no idea how many people they lost just running back and forth that round. Oh, there's only 8 seconds left. He can win the round just by holding Olofmeister. 6 seconds, he picks up the kill. Oh, he's going to get a flag with 3 seconds. Oh my god, if he had been hiding in a corner, he would have won the round. And that is a devastating way to lose a round. Hiko, I'm shedding a tear for Fnatic here.
Yeah, he had a decision to make. He either tries to push Banana and hope there's nobody there, or he stays in his position and hope the guy that's flanking him spawn. He knew there was a guy coming from spawn, but I feel like he probably thought there was a guy coming Banana as well. So there's no way he could have known they were both spawn, because I think if he did, he would have just pushed. So pretty close.
Pretty damn close indeed. What a game it's been so far, and well, VODS Pro, now it's swinging in their favor a fair bit. Not because they're sort of at the finish line, but the problem is that once they're at 13 rounds, and oh, look at this tiny, tiny detail by Neo, just tossing the AK away.
Throwing the gun over. Yep.
Yep. Very, very smart play. Just making sure nobody can pick it up. VODS Pro aren't leaving much to chances here. Olofmeister goes down, and Flusher can't really do anything at this point in a 1-on-3. But no, it's going to be 13-7, but the really big problem is that Fnatic's economy is going to be so bad in the almost the rest of this game, it feels like, unless they just start winning a lot of consecutive rounds, that it really allows for no mistakes. We're talking flawless game from here on out.
Yeah, here, I mean, that's very true. Fnatic needs to win this round. This is the round. If there ever was a round they need to win, it's this one. And, I mean, JW has an op, so their passive style, I mean, they're just kind of getting shut down everywhere, it seems like, on their CT. I mean, they're close rounds, but it still feels like VODS Pro is just taking over everything. So if JW can get an early pick, let's see where he's going. If he gets this early pick mid, I think they're looking pretty solid.
That would be a really good start. We'll see if it's actually going to happen. I like this Pasha boosted up on looking over the smoke, which is something that a lot of teams are doing. The problem is a lot of CT sides have now started actually just shooting through at the top there. So everyone is adjusting to this kind of boost that we're seeing. Definitely something a lot of teams have done recently. But it can still work out. You see Olofmeister just pre-firing it. They definitely know. So not really much of a chance there for VODS Pro, and they're going to fall back. JW still hasn't found an opening, but there's still time.
Here comes the smokes for the A-execute.
Yep. Taz going to throw one over towards Archway. And, well, Flusher, he's going to position himself on the other side of it. So now gets flashed as well, trying to fall back here. Flashing out just to make sure they can't catch him, which is a pretty good move. But they're still pushing forward. They're not stopping VODS Pro right here. And he spots a lot of them. He's going to need backup. He just pushes in. Why on earth did he do that? I think that could have been handled much better by Flusher or by Fnatic in general. JW goes down. Pronax falls. And now Olofmeister and Crims are in a 2-on-5, trying to somehow miraculously retake it. Doesn't feel doable.
I love watching VODS Pro for rounds like that. Their executes, like, the way they win the rounds like that, I just love watching. They had the A execute smokes. They had the smokes everywhere. The flash is over. They went 4 towards the long side. And obviously Flesha made a pretty questionable play pushing that smoke and trying to kill them, but they were able to kill him, kill a big pit guy. They had two Molotovs, one for the in the site and one for behind Pope. And it was just a really just clean round. And again, I love watching virtus.pro for rounds like that.
It definitely was really impressive, and Olofmeister is going to survive. Now,
the thing that I
question about the way Flesha played that is there's sort of a couple of different ways. If you want to peek and you know they're out on towards archway, you can either throw a flashbang up on the wall by the A, or sort of up on the roof by the A bomb site, and it sort of bounces off. You can do that yourself, but because Fnatic actually had two players down in pit, I'm wondering why one of the pit players didn't just throw a grenade out for him. It would have been a pop flash, and he could have peeked right behind it. Instead, he peeked without any flashes, and well, we saw the result.
Yeah, it's a long nade to throw, especially because they knew that Snacks was in halls too. So it was probably just a heat of the moment thing. They didn't have really enough time to do that.
Well, JW is down to half, but they still picked up the opening kill. Actually, he did leg shot Pasher as well. So in terms of beginnings, this is a really good one for Fnatic, but they have half the rounds that virtus.pro have, and it's 14-7 at the moment. Things are looking very tricky here for the Swedish team. And the really weird thing is that it could have been so different. I feel like this score might as well right now have been like 10-12 or so, like, you know, just much closer at this point. But virtus.pro have got away with a lot of really cool rounds, and Fnatic have thrown a couple of easy rounds away.
Yeah, definitely. There are definitely rounds there where virtus.pro should not have won.
Alright, now they're in a 4-on-5, and Fnatic kind of can just sit and wait for virtus.pro to do something. They have the man advantage, and I'd be surprised if they do anything crazy here. Snacks is going to flash his way into pit, and actually, in spite of all the flashes, managed to get down there. He sees JW is so close, wants to jump up and take the shot, but Pronax right there as well. Snacks is just wasting a lot of time here for Fnatic. Until they kill him, they got to wait. But over at the banana, they do manage to take care of business. Taz, the only one here, Gus get a kill, and time has run out for virtus.pro. So actually, in spite of the fact that Snacks hasn't picked up a kill yet, and maybe he won't, I still think this was a very cool play by him.
Counter-terrorists win. Watch the end of this.
Oh,
yeah,
man. He goes down after the time.
Yeah, so he has no money right now. Or he has the money from last round. But so Snacks comes out halls, right, and jumps in the pit. And at that time, it cues Olofmeister to peek mid. He peeked mid, he cleared it. There was nobody there, so he takes into his own hands to walk down mid and flank the guys going B. I think that was a huge play by Olofmeister to make, and I think they won the round because of him right there.
Yeah.
Even and with a guy in big pit, like that's a big play to make. I'll say the BDP. He definitely made a BDP right there.
It's a really, really scary play to make, especially if you get picked off at that point and they just rush the B bomb site. All of a sudden, you're in a weird position, and Snacks was still alive, so you're right. It would have been even worse, actually. Well played, Olofmeister. Gotta give him some credit for that one. Now they're trying to see if they can get up here. JW blocking Pronax, and they managed to get around the corner, but that could have been a horrible situation for the two Swedes right there. Don't really want to try and body block each other up there. But what's the plan? virtus.pro, they have a lot of rounds to play with here before they at least make it to match and map point. But I mean, are they just testing right now, do you think, to see which bomb site is weaker?
I think so. I mean, they've been doing the same thing. They kind of teeter totter between the sites. They fake A and they go back to B. And then sometimes they'll throw in like a random A execute. And it looks like this round they're going to go towards a little bit heavier B than they've usually done. I actually like this. I think their B success has been better than their A success so far this half.
Oh, this Molotov is going to be rough. They're actually just running right through the poles. They just don't care about that fire. They keep pushing it, but there's a lot of people here defending. Fnatic have a really great hold. Krim's almost shooting his teammate then. Taz taking damage, and he is alone. So we're looking at a flawless round here from Fnatic. 9-14.
Yeah, I think virtus.pro needs to do like their AXQ a little bit, like, or their A default like normal, and let Fnatic only have one B, because that's what they've been doing. And a lot of teams, when a team does that, so there's a smoke at the bottom banana, there's a guy like the CT's at the tree or underneath the porch thing. Yeah. So usually what teams will do is they'll throw a flash through the smoke and just try to bombard him, and he'll be the only guy there. So I think that might be a thing that virtus.pro could do, but they have to sell it so that there's only one there late.
Oh, Fnatic being the ultimate teammate, taking down Snacks, who was actually about to challenge JW and probably kill him. That was a little bit scary. But it works out all right, and JW is going to return the favor and get another kill right here. Pronax will take down Taz, and obviously it's an eco round that we're seeing here from virtus.pro, so not really too exciting, but I guess any kill matters. I mean, if virtus.pro can take rifles away from Fnatic in an eco like this, then, you know, they're setting themselves up for victory later.
Yeah.
So, what kind of... I mean, you said you sort of liked the B-push, and obviously that B-push got a little bit destroyed because Fnatic actually had time to rotate another player in, and they had a Molotov, but do you think they should go for B again this time, virtus.pro?
Well, it's hard to say. They know JW's opening, so they know that he has to be trying to get information early and mid, and actually, it looks like this round... Is he going towards B? No, he's not, but they have 3 B this round, so... They, you know, here's what I said. They take B control. They have it. They're going to leave one guy alone there. Now, virtus.pro needs to make sure they don't push behind them, make sure they don't, you know, get the information they need and go back to B. I think that's, you know, going A late hasn't been working for them because, as I said, that second guy B falls back to A and they're trying to execute against 4 people.
Yeah, so now it's a little bit of time has passed and Fnatic still don't have a lot of information, but JW will still pick up a kill up in the hallways, which is very unfortunate for virtus.pro. They did need that good opening, and they'll actually get it in return with a grenade. Snags going to take down one. Flusher with the return instantly. Taz goes down, and Flusher looking for a double. He's going to get it as well. Now it's a 2-on-3, and are they going to keep pushing this A-bomb site? They will. Flusher right around the corner. Already headshot once, I think, and he's going to fall back. I think that was a shot through the wall as well, and now Pasha is alone in a really tough position, especially with Crims controlling the bomb from mid here. Pasha walking in, not fast enough. JW will take him down. I don't know, that ended up being a 1-on-3, but it could have been, I think, a little bit closer for virtus.pro. If they'd taken down Flusher earlier on, that would have probably been a big opening.
It's possible, but again, Olafmeister was right next to him. They had two there. Even if somebody trades on Flusher, I feel like Olafmeister gets the trade right back. So they have to, I mean, they have to know at this point that once that smoke's at the bottom of B, they only have one guy there. And finally, we see JW go for a pick at banana. I like it.
Yeah, grenade on one, takes damage there. JW's grenade also doing a lot. And now when he falls back and they think, all right, we're so close, he just has an orb. There are actually two people bodyguarding him with automatic rifles. That's a sick shot coming out from Snags. Oh, JW's not going to forgive that one easily. Now he's flashing his way through. Snags is a monster. What is he doing? Just running for the smoke. If he had got that kill on Crims, that would have been absolutely monstrous. Yeah, JW definitely has to give some credit for that one.
I'm surprised. If Taz has a Molotov right now, I'm surprised they didn't kind of go a little slower, wait a little bit longer, and maybe throw like the Molotov executed B that all the teams throw. Especially, I mean, now that's, what, $600 down the drain pretty much. There's no way he's going to use it. There's no way he's going to save. So just wasted $600.
Yeah, and he's being shot through the smoke and grenaded through, and he's going to go down eventually. He's in the cart ready to be, you know, hauled off to somewhere else because he's obviously not going to win that round. 14-12, and we are into the 27th round. I mean, I don't know, Hiko. This gap is closing right now.
Yep, you have the players on Fnatic nearing 16k, so they're going to probably be able to buy every round here on out. virtus.pro, they need to win. They need to find something. They need to find an opening. And I really believe it's B. They're going up A is not working. JW just getting a pick too early every round. And again, right there, he almost got that pick. If they did, virtus.pro would be looking horribly right now. But like, so they do the same thing every round, virtus.pro. They take halls. They're clearing halls. They throw this flash that goes, that flashes the boilers. Who's throwing it? Taz just threw it right there. There it is. Fnatic knows they're clearing halls now. Fnatic is going to pull that second guy out of B. There he is. He's already at A. So they have 4 at A right now. Now, virtus.pro needs to go back to B. They haven't been able to win against the 4 guys at A. So, I mean, it looks like, though, they're setting up to just go up mid, but they might still fall back.
Well, Pronax is going to peek up here. Snags got to be really careful. Pronax is just seconds away. He's going to peek up and take him down. Things looking scary right now for virtus.pro. But, I mean, Hiko, we're realizing this because we have the overview. Maybe how difficult is it once you're in the game to actually see what's happening?
It's hard, but I mean, they should know that they throw the same flash every round. They do the same jump every round. They're throwing the same smokes and nades every round, pretty much. So, oh, Pasha.
Oh, looking good, but Pronax with the double return. He's in the fire. He jumps back down, but if he'd have stayed, he might have died anyway. Now it's on Taz, and he is going to pick up the kill. He's kind of low, but Crims is... got the M4A1 ready here. Just 13 bullets left. Taz has time to reload as well with the bomb plant. If he wins this, it'll be absolutely huge for VODS Pro. That means they get a lot of weight off their shoulders. At least they will draw the game. And Crims, he's going to have to try and clutch this. Taz just waiting and buying time. And Crims sneaking up. He just has to hit one shot right here. But Taz is hiding. It's not easy. Now the Deagle has come out here. He can't find it. Taz doing a great job of hiding. He's still going to go down. Oh, no. He almost bought the time, Hiko.
It was so close. Pasha made a huge play running through his smoke, killing two in the site. And then, who was it? Was it Pronax that was on top of the Pope? Just killing two from above, like, the graveyard area? It was a nice play by him to go over the smoke and kill them. But, yeah, that's very unfortunate. I feel like that was Virtus Pro's round. If Virtus Pro can't win that round, I don't know anymore. Now it's looking kind of grim.
It's a little bit scary, and the big thing I think they did that round compared to the other rounds when they went A is they actually made it all the way over to the pit. I mean, they ran all the way into the bomb site almost before Fnatic started to really shoot at them, and that was just thanks to great smokes and flashes. So maybe if they can repeat that, but you know, you have been mentioning for a while, yeah, the opening pick from JW, and there it is again. He's not quite top fragging, but he's at 24, and Olofmeister is at 27. So those two right now, they're steamrolling Virtus Pro.
Yep, and now since it's a 4v5, the second guy B shouldn't even bother rotating. The second guy B should stay B, keep 2B, keep 3A, and it's going to be very, very hard for Virtus Pro to come back into this round.
Oh, man. 14-13, but... Oh, great grenade from Neo. What I was going to say is that I think there's also a psychological thing going on for Fnatic. I think once you tie the game and you know you just have to win two more rounds, that's where I often see in the past, at least, a lot of teams start making weird mistakes. Like, it's easier It's easier winning, like, six rounds in a row, but the last two somehow seem more difficult. We'll see. Pushes on towards the B bomb site. Olofmeister with a good pickoff. A second one as well. Only has a tiny gap, but he picks up the double anyway. Now he just has to wait. Stay alive. Wait for his teammates to come. But he is going to peek a little bit early. Maybe a little bit of a shame there. It's still a 2-on-3. Bomb is going down here with just a few seconds left, but now they're charging through. And Virtus Pro trying to cover from every angle all at once. And they will actually be successful. Now it's down to Flusher in a 1-on-2. Can they seal the deal this time, Virtus Pro? That's so close. And there it is.
Oh, no.
Neo with the triple. And that was a 2-on-4 victory for Virtus Pro. Fnatic, they came so close. I mean, they had that round. I think if Olofmeister, not to put too much pressure on him, because he's top fragging, he's almost dropping a 30 bomb. But if he had stayed alive for another 3 seconds behind that, that would have probably been it.
Yeah. If he didn't peek, just give him like 2 more seconds for JW to push through the smoke. I think that round goes in their favor. And I guess maybe that psychological thing that you were talking about just hit them. You know, that was a kind of a questionable play. They won the last six in a row that before this last round. So maybe they're kind of overconfident now. They've won so many in a row. They're making plays that they probably shouldn't.
That's what I've seen before in the past as well, and I can't really blame them either. I think when you're as far behind as Fnatic were earlier, I think it's easier to accept that you might lose the game. I mean, every team has lost a lot of games, so you get kind of used to it in the end, I assume. But, you know, losing the game at, you know, 16-7, you just feel like, all right, it was a bad loss for us, we had a bad day, whatever, we'll move on. But once you make it back to 14-14, that's when you start to really have some emotional investment into the winner, you know, again, maybe. Oh, Pronax gonna get a great pickoff here on Bayali, and what are we down to now? 5-on-3? Not looking good for Virtus Pro once again, and if they lose here, they're gonna be so low on money. We might just end up with a draw here.
Is there no overtime in SLTV?
There's no overtime. Neo trying to stop it and doing a fine job, but he's realized there's another guy here. That's the thing. Normally, there's only two people holding B, so Neo doesn't even think about it. And Flusher playing it really smartly. He wanted actually to hear both members before he really shot there. So just really smart play from Flusher. And now, well, Taz in a bit of a predicament here. Very, very low on health and with not a lot of time left. 10 seconds. They just got to wait until he plants. He can't fake it. He's got a straight plant here. Otherwise, he's just going to lose. He fakes it, and now they just have to wait. Yep. And there it is. JW goes for the kill. All right, then. What are we witnessing here? This is looking like a draw after all of this.
Exactly what you said. Virtus Pro won one round while they were on the max money they can get. So now they broke their money completely. They have CZs, armor, very minimal nades, only one rifle in their hands. With JW having it off, they almost have to go B. Yeah, they are actually going to B.
Yeah, smart play. And, well, they'll take the one kill. Krim's still waiting right here, and he's going to pick up one. They need a lot more, and there's Krim's picking it down. So now it's just on. Neo has picked up an AK, but he'll go down. So, Hiko, after all that trouble, we end up with a tied game. Who would have thought?
When you made the comment, Virtus Pro has now doubled Fnatic score, it's now 14-7, I thought for sure. I mean, maybe that was the jinx right there, though, right? Maybe that's what jinxed it.
It could have been in that case, I'm sorry, but that was a weird game, definitely. But I think it says something about the strength of Fnatic. I think they've improved quite a lot with this new lineup. Virtus Pro, as you said, is a really good team on Inferno, so a little bit surprised. But hey, that puts us on to our next match, guys, which is going to be, I think, maybe a little bit more one-sided game. It's Virtus Pro versus USSR. That's going to be up in about 5 minutes. So don't go far. We'll just put on a little bit of music, and then we will be right back after these commercial messages.